let's all pick a swing. Okay? We have plenty of room at the moment, so if you're a teacher and you want to be practicing with us, feel free to grab a swing. Okay, if you guys want to just take notes, that's 100% okay as well. So I'm going to start from the beginning. Like, we've never experienced this before, even though I know some of you guys have been here before. So I'm Jen Healy. Thank you for being here. So happy to have you. So this is called the Aerial Yoga Play Program. So it's a combination of yoga, some aerial, some acrobatics, but today we're going to do therapeutics. So it's really going to be yoga translations and some basic series that we've been learning. This is the teacher training. So these lovely teachers are being certified. This is Navina.
Hi.
Just going to introduce everybody. Do you guys know Tirza? She's popular around here. Sam. Sam's reviewing. So John. Wendy. And then Connie. So we have lots and lots of people here to help. So we can like buddy up and have lots and lots of attention, or we'll just let you have some fun and check out the swings. So I make these swings, they're super special, so check it out, they're really stretchy. So come up and just get a feel for them. Everything spreads out so you can get into it, which is like just super special. Secret sauce. And then we all have leg loops and hand holds to play with. So make sure you have two hand holds and two leg loops. We've checked the swings, we can adjust the swings if you need. We're going to start out with the swings behind our back. There's a couple different sequences we're going to try. We're going to open up the heart, and we're going to open up the hips. These are the two major hubs of the body. Right? So I love the name of the studio, Move to Change. There's a lot of marching going on today, and a lot of people showing up in the world in order to create positive change, and we're just swinging to change today, right? So we're using the swing as part of our own empowerment practice. How can we really open, align, and release to empower ourselves to create a new reality, to see a new perspective, to make a real difference, not only for our own inner world, but our outer world. So we're just using this inspiration of the day to invite us to go deeper. How can we move from a heart-centered reality to really change our perspective? Instead of head first in the world, let's move heart first. So to do that, we're gonna shift our alignment, shift our posture. So the swing is super soft and stretchy and comfortable, but it's still gonna be intense as it hits these sensitive parts of the body. So I want you to really take your time with it, move nice and slow through the postures. Since this is kind of like a semi-private experience, we encourage you to ask for what you need, have a conversation with me. If there's talking amongst you, I just get really distracted, so if you don't mind, we'll all just focus this way, and I happily accept your suggestions or feedback, so feel free to ask me if there's anything you need. And then we're going to use the swing, like I said, to support us behind the heart to begin, and then we're going to use the swing in our hips, so those are the two main hubs of the body that we're going to work on today. So let's use our forearms to push the swing down. So you'll notice if you just stand, the swing is kind of hitting the armpits. So if we hang by our underarms too long, it's not going to feel great. So we're going to learn how to push the swing down and create an anchor point at the lower part of the ribs. And then when we sit back, we're going to hold on. First, hold on. Walk your feet forward. We'll use these cute round red mats to inform the movements in the space. And then forearm press. So you notice it's not even touching the underarms, right? So from here, we're going to move into a sumo squat. So bend the knees and start to heel toe your feet together. Get out to about a 45 degree angle. Right? So my toes are touching the front of the mat. Beautiful, guys. And then let your hips hang. You let your hips hang. Can the heart open, but the hips be relaxed. So we practice this engaged but relaxed. And then just let yourself wiggle a little bit from side to side. Right? Just let yourself find a little bit more ease and flow and grace and movement. Even when we're learning something new, how can we really just kind of slow it down, get used to, it's like a new relationship. Getting used to the trust, we're getting used to the holds. And if at any time this feels uncomfortable, it feels like the swing's riding up too much, we're gonna press our legs straight. Everybody press straight back. Okay? Use your forearms to kind of wiggle. Good. Lots of wiggling. So we get the swing nice and low. And then we bend our knees again and back into our sumo squat. Yeah, that looks great. So it's actually hooking the wings. So it's the bottom tip of the shoulder blades. If it goes up like this, then we look like a scarecrow. It's not quite it. Okay? So we straighten our legs. Let's try one more time. Get the swing at the lower part of the ribs, right behind the heart. Let's open up our arms wide. Let's shake it out, shake it out. Superstar, jazz hand. Shake, shake, shake. Straight legs, press back. And then use our relaxing arms. So this is the other position that I like to teach, where we're supporting the back of the head to open up the heart. Slightly traction the neck, so we're pulling and creating a little bit more space there for the cervical spine to feel really yummy, really good. And then from here, we're going to bend the knees again, come back wide with the arms, and then forward, press, sumo squat. So from our sumo squat, let's add a little bit more of a twist. So let's bring the left knee down, twist all the way, let's open that way. Left knee down, pull the knee back up, sumo squat. Let's bring the right knee down. Nice. Don't worry about the alignment yet. Just hang. Hang completely. Okay, really good. One more time. Twist. Left knee comes down. Ooh, la, la. If we want to press our forearm, our left forearm into the swing, we can go a little bit deeper. Press, press, press. Nice. Come back through center. Drop the right knee. Press, press, press. So we're pressing the right forearm into the swing to bring out the spine. Beautiful, guys. Okay, so we can go from side to side, bring the feet a little bit wider. Just gonna control the music with the phone. Let me know if the music's too loud for you back there, okay? Let's go ahead and just pulse here. So we're gonna bend the left knee, just hang out. So we're not up in a warrior two, we're actually just hanging out. So, left knee bent, good. Press your hips towards me, I call it making a wish. So you're spreading the hips out, ooh, la la, there it is, really good. And then we press straight back. Change sides. Just pulse. Pulse for a couple breaths. If it feels intense, you're in the right place. Smile if you can. Nice. Press straight back. One more time. Let's come into it. So if you drop the hips and square the hips towards me and then press them forward, it's totally different than our normal warrior two poses. This movement is happening. Press straight back. Forearms lift the chest. Bend the right knee and just hang out and pulse. Can we let the hips find a little bit more softness and a little bit more ease while the upper body stays nice and engaged? You guys are awesome. You're all doing it. Makes my job so much easier. Okay, come back to center. We're going to heel-toe the feet together. Wiggle it. So I like to bring the feet close to the front of the mat. So we can try to sway from side to side here. So play, right? How much play, how much curiosity, how much exploration can we bring to the swing? There you go. So we have some natural players today. And then we can also use our chillaxing arms here. I call it weeping willow. So we're going to make sure we don't get into any bumper car action. Make sure you can have enough space. Pay attention to the pillars and the poles and the people and all the other things that are around us. Ground your feet. Nice strong legs to allow the upper body to just sway in the space. Notice if we're leaning back, we're massaging out that tightness behind the heart as well. Let it feel good for the swing to hold you and assist you in going deeper into a back bend. Okay, head is supported in the hands. Heart open, head back. A strong, rooted foundation for the legs. Mm-hmm. From here, we're going to slow it down. We're going to find center. I'm going to turn around so we can all do our angel wings together. You guys stay where you are. This is a really fun way to fly. So from here, we're going to open up our arms wide. Take a nice big inhale. As we exhale, we start to bend the knees and we just pendulum swing forward. Good. And inhale, come back. Arms overhead. Exhale, pendulum forward. Inhale up. Exhale, swing. And now this time we're going to do our biggest expression. Exhale forward and now take a big inhale. Inhale here. Exhale back. Whee! All the way. Inhale, come forward. Exhale back. Inhale forward. Nice. Angel. Okay. See if you can bend a little from side to side. Keep pushing the hips forward. It's a little intense. Just stay with it. And then bend the knees nice and slow. Pendulum swing. All right, back to our weeping willow. Stay here. Helps if we all go in the same direction for that one, otherwise we'll get a little up. feet down, hips sway from side to side, upper body completely relaxed. Massage out that space behind the heart. Really nice guys. Heart opening practice, right? We allow our heart to gain a little bit more space. Clearing the elbows out, find center. Inhale, open up wide. Let's do one more round with jazz hands. Shake it out, shake, shake, shake. And then forearm press. Okay, let's come into a little twist here, reclined twist. Pick the left knee up, roll onto the outer edge of the right, flex the foot back, and then step. Don't worry about the alignment so much as it feeling good to bring out the spine. If you can, the foot comes up really high to meet the hip. But we're walking your toes up to the edge of the mat. Okay? So this is okay, but this would be better. If you can get your foot out a little further. Yeah, there it is. So we're trying to stack the bones to create this nice long line of energy. From there, look back over the left shoulder, bring out the spine. Exhale, drop the hips. Inhale, lift and twist. Ooh la la. Exhale, drop. Inhale, lift, twist. Exhale, drop. Beautiful. Pick the left foot up. Shoot it out in front of you. Flex your toes back, drop your hips, wiggle it. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Good. Keep the feet flexed. Roll into the outer edge of the left. Good. Pick up the right knee and then stack. So right angle, right angle, right angle. Beautiful, guys. Straight leg with the left. Right knee bent. Inhale, lift and twist. Look over the right shoulder. Exhale, drop straight down, straight down. You're going to feel the whole side body open on the left side there. Really intense. Inhale, lift. Exhale, drop. Pulse a little bit in space. Inhale. Exhale. Let it feel good. Nice, guys. Go ahead and pick that foot back up. Find center. Take a moment to wiggle. Drop, drop, drop. Wiggle it out. So if that is too much on the arms, remember a bit of press. Get the swing a little bit lower. Take a little break. Let's come into our T, angel wings. Go ahead and shake it out. And then clasp the hands behind the back of the head, chillaxing. As always, use our chillaxing arms to reset, add a little bit more swagger in the swing. I call it swagger when we sweep from side to side. Don't worry about syncing up yet. I'll do a lot of synchronized swimming, but right now you can just have your own free flow. What does it feel like to close your eyes and trust the support of the swing to help you go deeper? If that feels like too much, just find a focal point. See if there's more space that can happen. Maybe you can make your sway a little bit bigger, rolling it out to the side, coming into a little roundabout. Enjoy how much room we have, this beautiful space that we get to play in. And then when you're ready, we're going to come to center. Beautiful. Let's do one more, then we're going to give a break. So we're going to lift the left knee up and we're going to shoot it back into a forward lunge. See if we can find the back toes staying tucked under so we have the capacity to lift the knee if we want. So one way to do this pose is just to hold on to the swing and kind of pulse, right? Feel the balance. Good. Really nice. So that might be enough. And if anybody wants to try a little bit more of the back bend, we've been doing a lot of arching, we can press our forearms in. We're going to inhale, lift up and over, gaze back behind you. And then exhale, come to neutral rest. If anybody has any neck issues, anybody have any injuries they wanna? Yeah, so I was like feeling that. Go ahead and support your neck with your hands, like chillaxing. And then inhale, lift and pull straight up and out, right? So you always keep a little bit of space there. And you get big opening through the front of the body without crunching the neck. Okay, so come back to neutral. So option one, use your hands to pulse, right? Which also feels good. Are you still getting the opening? A little bit of a back bend, forearm press. Go ahead and lift and stretch so you're opening up that whole line through the quad and psoas. And then the last one, come to neutral. Let's use our chillaxing arms and feel what it's like to lean back into it and still pull the back of the neck. And we're getting this amazing stretch through the quad. Nice. Okay, come on back up. Hold on to the swing. I would straighten both legs, wiggle it. Come to a bigger twist here. So most of the time I just get into this one leg play. Right? Can we open the body in a really easy, graceful way? Have some fun with it. Let's look at maximum benefit. Right? So all we have to do is get into swing and play. Whee! Nice, you guys look awesome. Those teachers that are taking notes, will you go ahead and take some photos here and there? If you guys are okay with it, it looks so beautiful. Okay, great. One more leg. Let's go ahead and hold on to the swing. Pick the right knee up, shoot it back into a lunge. So we're helping ourselves to get into position. I like to keep the toes tucked under. Obviously, you can drop down. Let's see if you can kind of stack here. Wiggle the front foot forward a little bit more. Beautiful. So it's a pulse. Inhale up. Like a little bicep curl. Inhale up. Right? So that if I was working with somebody who had difficulty getting into lunges in a normal yoga class, this would really help them, right? It's keeping their spine nice and long, their head stuck so they're not head diving. Right? So I'm just lifting. So let's try a forearm press. Come to neutral. Take a breath. Inhale. Press, press, press. Lift the chest. Roll up and over. So you're pushing your back of the heart into the swing. Come into your fullest expression. That should be nice and strong. And then exhale, relax. Woo! Beautiful. Let's try one more version. Chillax in arms. Inhale, lift, press, press, press. So we're pressing the back of the heart into the swing to lift up. Okay, so if anybody wants to straighten the front leg, you can try to bring your hands or your head to your heel. You know, get extra brownie points. It's just a fun variation. Come all the way back. Beautiful. Hold on to the swing. Straighten both legs. Beautiful, guys. Let's go ahead and neutralize the spine. A little bit more swing from side to side. Just take a moment to integrate and feel what just happened in the belly and in the body. It's a really big opening. Let's go ahead and come to neutral. Inhale, open the arms wide. Exhale, forearm press. Sumo squat. One more time, sumo squat. See if we can get a bigger shift from side to side. It's kind of like belly dancing. So instead of just moving linearly, we're actually twisting and spinning. See if we can loosen up the pelvis. Nice. So if it feels good, you're in the right place. Just experiment a little bit with it. All that stickiness starts to loosen up. Lubricating the hip joints in all directions. Okay, great. So hold on to the swing, then press the heart forward, hips back, wide straddle, elbow tuck, hips back. So we can come into proper patty, but then we get the sensation. So that's a strong press, right, for the forearms. So we sink our hips back over our ankles. I like to say wide center with the feet. Wide center. Does that make sense? Yeah. So a little bit more forward, Sam. To find the center. Yeah, wide center. Good. Now let's go ahead and add a little bit more sway. Trace the shape of the mat with our gaze. Pause at the edges and feel what happens in the rib cage. Through the outer shin, what happens in the hips. Take your time to explore the space. Beautiful, guys. Great. Maybe we're feeling like low gear and we want to do smooth jazz. Maybe we're feeling like a little bit more dynamic strength and movement. Wherever you are, just take your time. So nice flat back from tailbone to the crown of the head. Nice long line of energy through the body. Okay, so Sasha, see your head. In line, so your heart first instead of head first, right? Beautiful. If it bothers your neck at all, it's okay to drop. This is actually going to start to strengthen the whole front of the spine. Let's come to neutral. Drop left hand down right underneath the heart. Okay, so right hand, we're going to make a fist. And then when we twist, we're going to try to pull our fist towards our sternum. Bring up the spine. Just exhale, come to neutral, look down. Inhale, twist. Pull with your fist. Twist. Nice. Exhale, straighten out. Inhale, twist. All right. Beautiful. Reach that hand towards the sky. It's going to catch the swing. Hold on to the swing. Straight arm. Mm-hmm. We're going to swing it overhead. Swing the swing. Once you have an X in the swing, you thread both hands through. can interlace the fingers. So if anybody has any shoulder issues, you can bend the elbows a lot, and that makes the shoulders happy. If you want to do straight arms, you can get a really big opening through the front of the chest, with slow working on opening the heart. And then just add a little swagger to the swing. Just tiny little micro movements from side to side to explore the space. And only if it feels good, you can bend the knees. Anytime it feels like too much, bend the elbows, bend the knees. That'll keep the joints nice and safe. Beautiful. Come to center. Inhale, press, press, press. Use your arms to lift you up. Exhale, come down. Inhale, press, press, press. Good. Just three pulses. Exhale, come down nice and slow. See how slow we can go. It's the game we're playing. All right, inhale, press, 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 and come to stand. Coming up for a second. I'm going to show you why we're doing this exercise. This is a little bit more like the T-Rex or Pilates version. But if all goes well today, we're going to get into Superfly. And it's easy to press when your feet are on the ground because you can kind of cheat a little and use your back. When we come into Superfly, we're going to use those same muscles to press and come up like this. So we need to press, 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 and come up. So I want you to practice lifting your chest, your head in line with your body, so that when your hands press down, your heart comes up. Okay? Well, we're going to support you to come into Superfly. That's what we're working up to today. Okay? Let's try it one more time. We have two arms, so we're here. Let's come back into our X. Wide straddle, center. It's just always good to know where we're going with it, right? So we want to build the strength and the alignment in order to lift. So try to press your hands down and lift your heart. Press, 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 come up. Press, press. Yeah, that's it. Nice. Let's remove the left arm. Come bring it overhead. Bend the elbow, we hook, drop in, second side. Yeah, beautiful. All right, two arms, right? So we make a fist. We're gonna pull the fist down towards our sternum as we bring out the spine and look towards the sky. Exhale, go ahead, just relax back down. If this is too much on your neck, just keep looking down. Inhale, twist. Engage. Exhale, lower. Just giving you a little sample. What we can do, let the hand be right at the front of the mat instead of under the heart. There you go. Inhale, twist. Relax. Okay, one more time. Hand straightens. We hook. Bring it overhead. Lift. Bend the elbows a lot. Everybody bend. La-da-da. So play, explore, twist, wiggle, shift a little bit from side to side. So notice with the elbows bent, we're getting a little bit more into the underbelly of the arm, and we're gonna practice strengthening the triceps this time. So when you're ready, when you feel like you've done enough exploring, come to center. Take a breath. We're gonna inhale, so the triceps, right? So hold on really strongly so you're wrapping around. There you go. Press, press, press. Lift the chest, remember, like we're like doing Superfly. Press. Exhale, lower, bend the elbows nice and slow. Let that feel good. Inhale, press. Press. Feel your whole belly stretch when you go nice and slow. Nice. One more time, go ahead and hang. So just let the heart kiss the ground. Just open up the shoulders and hang out here. Shake out your head, shake out your thoughts, reset. Now we're gonna inhale, come to stand, nice and slow. Lift the chest. Heart, hit the line of the body, and come on up. All right. Feet together. Just take a moment. Shake it out. Shake it out. So just notice how different the upper body already feels, right? I'm going to lose the extra layer anymore now. Anytime you need a sip of water, potty break, whatever it is, feel free to take care of yourself. So anybody want to